Is it like that we don't use degrees of planets in Gemini astrology? Is it so? No, it is not this way. So, generally, it is believed that the Charaka, Atmakarak, Amatyakarak, Bhratrikarak, Matrikarak, Putrakarak, Gyatikarak, Dharakarak of Gemini system is found based on degrees of planets, which is not entirely true. If one looks carefully at the shloka of Gemini, which talks about how to find these karak, it have clearly mentioned that minutes are to be used, right? Rashi, Amsha, Kala, Vikla. These are the four categorizations, right? People have been using degrees to find Atmakarak over the time, and many explanations are there for it as well. Many people who know Sanskrit have given explanations over it as well. But that does not matter. What matters is what the Rishi have written himself. And what the Rishi have written is to find the Atmakarak based on minutes. That is what we do as well. But then the question is that degrees of planets have no uses in Vedic astrology? Regarding Atmakarak, also there are multiple types of Atmakarak, right? Many of which I have mentioned in, I believe that there is a previous video where I have mentioned different type of Atmakarakas as well. All of these Atmakarak are used in different things in Gemini astrology. Someone is used for some purpose, someone is used for some other purpose. All of them have different uses, right? With respect to degrees, there are two places where the degrees of planets are used in Vedic astro in Gemini astrology particularly. And those two, three places I'm going to discuss in today's video, this video, with wish that you will get more insights into Gemini astrology. Talking of placement of planet at a particular place in zodiac, there are three things, right? Let's understand it. The zodiac is a circle of 360 degrees. Any circle is of 360 degrees. Zodiac is also a circle of 360 degrees. Now, it starts from 0 degree of Aries and ends at 30 degrees of Pisces. This is what happens. Now, if you talk about the longitude of planet, it is generally calculated with respect to 0 degrees all up to 360 degrees, right? Whenever we do addition, etc., in astrology, we do this, right? Basically, when we are writing planet is at 4 degrees Aries, or when we are writing planet is at 12 degree Taurus, or we are saying that planet is at 20 degree Pisces, what we are saying that planet at 4 degree Aries is at 4 degrees only. Whereas planet at 12 degrees in Taurus have covered 30 degrees of Aries and is into 12 degrees of Taurus. So it is basically in 42 degrees in the zodiac out of 360 degrees. And eventually planet into 30 degrees of Pisces, sorry, 20 degrees of Pisces have covered all the 30 degrees in the 12 Rashis, in the 11 Rashis up to Aries, right? So he have covered 30 degrees in 11 Rashis up to, sorry, Pisces, 330 degrees and up to Aquarius, and 20 degrees in Pisces, 350 degrees, right? How this 350 degree, 30 degree per Rashi? Planet is into Pisces, so he have covered 30 degree per Rashi up to Aquarius and is have crossed 20 degrees in Pisces. 20 degree Pisces means the planet is at 21st degree. That's why in a Vedic astrological horoscope, you will see planet is situated at 29 degrees only. Planet will be never situated at 30 degrees, right? 29 degrees means it has crossed the 29 degrees, right? This is astronomically how the planet is supposed to be calculated, right? Now, when we say highest degree planet, we are already ignoring the Rashi. So we are not taking the calculation completely from 0 degree to 360 degree. We are ignoring the Rashi and we are just taking the degree in Rashi. For example, take an example. A planet is situated at 24 degree Aries and another planet is situated at 4 degree Cancer. Now, if you just take the degree in Rashi, planet in 24 degree Aries will be higher as compared to planet in 4 degree Cancer. But in reality, planet in 24 degree Aries is only at 24 degrees out of the 360 degrees. Whereas planet into 4 degree Cancer have crossed 30 degrees of Aries, have crossed 30 degrees of Taurus, 30 degrees of Gemini, 90 degrees in total. Plus have crossed 4 degrees of Cancer, so it is a 94 degree. Right, so actually planet in 4 degree of Cancer is at higher place. But we are ignoring this, right? We are ignoring the Rashi. And we are not taking the planet to be between 0 degree to 360 degree, but only degree of the Rashi. Right? Why this ignorance is being done? Because apparently people are having the opinion that the Rishi have said so. But Rishi have not said to use degree in reality. Rishi is telling to use minutes in reality, right? So some people have this opinion that, okay, though minutes are told here, but even if we take degree, minutes are already included in the degree, so it should be planet in highest degree only. In that particular scenario, it should be planet having the highest longitude in the complete zodiac of 360 degrees, right? But you don't do that. We don't do that because the injunction of the Rishi is very clear that it have to be minutes only. Basic point, how we do the calculation of Atmakarak and other Karakas, right? Just understand a point that it is Atmakarak, Atma indicates self, and not Atmakarak, Atma means soul. Right, so it is the significator of self. And not of soul. This point should be highlighted in golden words at the first place itself. Now, with respect to degree of planet, do we not use it in Gemini astrology? We do. In Gemini system of astrology, we do it. At the first place, it is in deciding the strength of planet, deciding the strength of Rashi basically. Rashi or house. So in Gemini astrology, to find the reference point where to start the dasha from and all sort of things, one will have to find stronger one, right? Many a times. You will have to find a stronger Rashi, right? For example, starting dasha reference point. Sometimes it will be told that start the dasha from the stronger between Lagna or the seventh house, Lagna or the Adarsh Rashi, etc., etc. In such cases, the strength will be needed. Another thing is with respect to Argala. Right, it will be told to find the whether the Argala is powerful or the obstructing Argala is powerful. Argala is a very special thing in Gemini astrology. Argala makes sure that whatever result is indicated happens 100%, right? And because the surety principle, Argala principle is there in Gemini astrology, this is what makes the Gemini astrology very superior system. Here also you will have to find the strength. And in other scenarios as well, for example, you say 11th from Arud Lagna indicates income. 12th will indicate loss or expenditure, whatever you say. Now, if you have to find with respect to the person whether the person have more income or more expenditure to find out the actual money that one is having in hand, you will have to decide the powerful between them. So in many places in Gemini astrology and in normal astrology also, strength is needed. Finding the strength is needed is a necessity. And to do that, There are strength formulas. Strength formulas are many. In normal astrology also it is many, Gemini also it is many. And what is the guru gyan, right? What you learn from a teacher, what you learn with a teacher, what you learn from a guru is when to use which of them, right? This comes from experience, right? So that's why it is told in Vedic sciences, it is told in spiritual sciences that there is no substitute for a guru. Why there is no substitute for a guru? Because you see, either you can do all the hard work yourself, spend 10, 15 years and find which rule is, which source of strength is applicable where. You do it yourself, it will take 10, 15 years, many wrong horoscopes, right? Many wrong predictions and all of the things it will take. Or you can learn it from a teacher who have spent the 15 years, right? So that's why in all of such aparavidyas, right? Sorry, all of these paravidyas, it is particularly told to have a guru, right? Because otherwise there is a path of experimentation which takes a lot of time, right? Guru is a substitute of time. The practitioner is a substitute for time, right? Practitioner have spent a particular time in the subject, right? That's what is needed there. In these cases, strength is needed. What I was saying, in the strength, I have written an article, right? I have written an article, Strength of Rashi as per Gemini Astrology. That's an article from 2017 I have written. Now you say first source of strength, you come to first source of strength, atha pranaha. The first source of strength is Karak Yoga Prathamo Bhanam. Karak means doer. If there is a planet in Rashi, Karak Yoga Prathamo Bhanam means out of two Rashis you are comparing. If one Rashi is having a planet and another Rashi is not having a planet, the Rashi having planet is powerful. This is what means by Karak Yoga Prathamo Bhanam. But Karak, from the uses of the word Karak, it means the Rashi where significator is there. That Rashi is more powerful. Rahu Ketu cannot become the significator. So simple point is that a Rashi having planets out of Sun, Moon, Mars, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, and Saturn, that is considered powerful. Right? Planet having Rashi. What if both the Rashi in between which you are comparing, if both of them have planets, then Samya Bhuyasa. Right. If both signs are occupied by the planet, then the sign with more planet is more powerful. Right. Planet with Rashi with more planet is more powerful. So say both the two Rashis we are comparing is having planets. One is having two planet, one is having one planet. The Rashi having two planet is more powerful. If both the Rashis have equal number of planet, then Tathastungadi, right? Whichever Rashi have most powerful planet, that Rashi happens to be winner. Tungadi, Tunga means exalted, etc. So if there are equal number of planets in both the Rashis you are comparing, then the Rashi having more exalted planet, own Rashi planet, Mooltrikona planet, etc., that Rashi is to be considered as powerful. So see, in Gemini astrology, the point is that you apply the next formula only when the previous formula is not applicable, right? This is the primary difference between Gemini astrology and other systems of astrology. What happens? See, other system of astrology, suppose you have to find profession. Then what will happen? You will say there are four rules. You will apply all four of the rules and predict the result as per what the maximum of the rules indicate, right? This is normal. What you will call traditional astrology, Parashar astrology. What happens in Gemini astrology? Gemini astrology is structured. So like it is happening right now, right? You apply first source of strength. If that gives you result, all okay. Only if that is not applicable, you go to second source of strength. That is not applicable, you go to third source of strength and so on and so forth. This is how it goes. Third source of strength was Tathastungadi, right? If there are equal number of planets, then the Rashi having more power, more exalted own Rashi, Mooltrikona, etc. planets, that Rashi is powerful. If these three do not apply, you say either any of the Rashi is not having any planet, or both the Rashi have equal planets who are equally in strength, then you go to Nisargastatah. निसर्गस्तता, निसर्ग मीन्स नेचुरल स्ट्रेंथ. नेचुरल स्ट्रेंथ इज दैट मूव मोर पावरफुल देन मूवेबल साइन इज अ फिक्सेड साइन एंड मोर पावरफुल देन फिक्सेड साइन इज अ डुअल साइन. इफ इट गिव्स यू अ रिजल्ट दैट इज वेरी गुड. इफ इट ऑल्सो डज नॉट गिव यू अ रिजल्ट देन जनरली वाई कंपेयरिंग इन 11th एंड 12th फ्रॉम अरूर लग्ना दिस विल गिव यू द रिजल्ट. बट वेन कंपेयरिंग बिटवीन फर्स्ट हाउस एंड द सेवंथ हाउस, इफ फर्स्ट हाउस इज हैविंग मूवेबल राशि, सेवंथ विल ऑल्सो हैव अ मूवेबल राशि. इफ फर्स्ट इज हैविंग अ फिक्सड राशि, सेवंथ विल ऑल्सो हैव अ फिक्सड राशि. इफ फर्स्ट हाउस इज हैविंग अ डुअल राशि, सेवंथ विल ऑल्सो हैव अ डुअल राशि. दिस विल नॉट बी एप्लीकेबल, राइट? सो यू गो टू रूल नंबर 5, दैट इज तद्भावे स्वामिन इत्थम भावः. तद्भावे स्वामिन इत्थम भावः देन डिसाइड बाय तद्भावे स्वामिन देन डिसाइड बाय लॉर्ड ऑफ द राशि इत्थम भावः बीइंग सिचुएटेड इन अदर हाउसेस एटसेट्रा. देन डिसाइड बाय लॉर्ड, देन डिसाइड बाय लॉर्ड ऑफ राशि बीइंग पावरफुल एटसेट्रा. इफ द लॉर्ड ऑफ द राशिज, बोथ लॉर्ड ऑफ द राशिज आर इक्वली पावरफुल, देन वॉट यू डू? देन यू डू अग्रायतो अत्र विशेषात, देन द साइन लॉर्ड, राइट? नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ राशि लॉर्ड. दोज राशि लॉर्ड हु इज अग्रतो, अग्रतो मीन्स फॉरवर्ड. द राशि लॉर्ड हु इज फॉरवर्ड, दैट राशि इज पावरफुल. हियर इन दिस अग्र यतो अत्र विशेषात, हियर अग्र मीन्स फॉरवर्ड एंड हियर वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ पर्टिकुलरली. दिस अग्र यतो अत्र विशेषात, हियर ऑल्सो पर्टिकुलरली द डिग्री इज नॉट टोल्ड टू बी यूज, राइट? इट इज नॉट टोल्ड टू यूज डिग्रीज. Now, agra yato atra visheshat, the one who is forward is particularly very powerful. What it literally means, forward in the sense of the zodiac. The one who is forward in zodiac, higher in zodiac, is more powerful, stronger. So here the 360 degree calculation that I was telling you initially is applicable, is what is to be applied, right? For example, say there are two house laws. You are comparing between Aries and Libra. The Lord of Aries, Mars, is situated in Capricorn 12 degrees. The Lord of Libra is situated in, the Lord of Libra, Venus, is situated in Aquarius 2 degrees. Now, because planet Mars in Capricorn 12 degrees have covered 30 degrees per Rashi, up to the ninth Rashi of Sagittarians have covered 270 degrees already and is now have covered 12 degrees more, is at 282 degrees out of 360 degrees. Whereas Venus in Aquarius have crossed 30 degrees all up to the 10th Rashi of Aquarius, 10th Rashi of Capricorn, covered 300 degrees and now is at 2 degrees in Aquarius, is actually at 302 degrees out of 360 degrees. So Venus, which is in Aquarius, the Lord of Libra, is powerful. Venus is more powerful. Libra is more powerful. Here, while deciding strength, we are using degree of planets. Right. As I told you initially, there is Rashi, Amsha, Kala, and Vikala. There are 12 Rashis in the zodiac. Each Rashi have 30 Amsha. One Amsha will have 60 Kala and one Kala will have 60 Vikala. So basically Rashi and Amsha, when you see, is equal. Right, as a planet starts from 0 degrees of Aries and covers up to 30 degrees of Aries, he goes into the next Rashi, Taurus, and comes at 1 degree of Taurus. Right, so the complete zodiac is of 360 degrees, which is divided into 12 parts, making one Rashi of 30 degrees. So actually, Rashi and degree is equal. Certainly, degrees are made out of minutes. That is called kala. And minutes are made out of seconds, what is called vikla. This is the first place where the degree of the planet is used in Gemini astrology to decide between the strength. Even if this does not give you the answer, say both the planets are in the same Rashi, in the same degree, in which case it will make a planetary war from standard system of astrology. Then you go by Prativeshik Purusai. Prativeshik, that means if a male planet is situated in female Rashi or a female planet is situated in male Rashi, then in that particular scenario, right, the planet in different oddity, male planet in female Rashi, female planet in male Rashi should be considered powerful as compared to male planet in male Rashi, female planet in female Rashi. This is first source of strength. Regarding male planets and female planets, keep in mind Sun is a male planet. Mars is a male planet. Jupiter is a male planet. Saturn is a male planet. Rahu also is a male planet. Male Rashis are Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, Aquarius. Female planets are Moon, Mercury, Venus, Ketu. Female Rashis are Taurus, Cancer, Virgo, Scorpio, Capricorn, and Pisces. Right. So female planet in male Rashi and male planet in female Rashi is considered powerful. These are seven sources of strength in Gemini astrology. With respect to strength, from where to start, the dasha is an advanced method in Gemini astrology. I am certain that many of you do not know about it. But comparing between the houses such as 11th from Arul Lagna indicating income, 12th from Arul Lagna indicating loss in this setup, and in another setup of, and deciding between Argala or the obstruction being powerful, these sources of strength you should use. That is one thing, is where the degree of the planets is used in Gemini astrology. Another place where the degree of planet is used in Gemini astrology is finding the Dasha Karak. I will tell you, I absolutely love Rashi Dashans. Why I absolutely love Rashi Dashans? Because in Nakshatra Dashas, or what is Graha Dasha? See, Nakshatra, for example, take Vimshottari. Vimshottari is calculated based on Nakshatras, right? Moon is situated in a Nakshatra, that Nakshatra is lorded by a planet. So calculation happens based on Nakshatras, but Dasha is of a planet, right? Sun Dasha, Moon Dasha, etc. You will be going through. Rashi Dasha is better than this. Why? Say Graha Dasha is running, Venus Dasha is running. Now Venus is situated in one house, Venus is aspecting one house, Venus lords two houses, right? Then Venus will be in relationship with other planets, those other planets will be lord of few houses, they will be situated in few houses. Few houses can be aspecting Venus, there are some natural significations of Venus. So a lot of factors are there when you have to analyze Graha Dasha. These many factors makes the calculation cumbersome, sometimes difficult also. And generally, people cannot find the result with that clarity and confidence. In the other hand, what happens with respect to Rashi Dasha is that you have Dasha of a Rashi, you only have to see the Rashi and the Rashi Lord. More so, you make that Rashi as temporary ascendant for the Dasha period and analyze the result therefrom. It makes the calculation very simple and easy. That's why I prefer Rashi Dashas a lot. I will tell you a basic Rashi Dasha, which is very basic, works very accurately. Right. The method of analysis, so I have already told you just now. Basic Rashi Question. We have already discussed about male and female Rashi. Right. Male Rashi is Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, and Aquarius. Female Rashi is Taurus, Cancer, Virgo, Scorpio, Capricorn, and Pisces. If it is a male Rashi, the calculation of the dasha will be, first there will be the dasha of the first house, then second house, third house, fourth house, fifth house, sixth house, seventh house, eighth house, ninth house, 10th house, 11th house, and 12th house. In the case of a male Rashi, this is called direct calculation. In the case of a female Rashi, it will be reverse calculation. So first there will be dasha of first house, then of 12th house, then 11th house, then 10th house, then 9th house, then 8th house, then 7th house, then 6th house, then 5th house, then 4th house, then 3rd house, and lastly there will be the dasha of second house. This is called reverse calculation. Right. So based on the ascendant being male or female, the order of dasha, you decide. After deciding this order of dasha, now what naturally happens with nakshatra dasha such as Vimshottari, Kalchakra dasha, Yogini, etc., you have to find dasha bhukta bhogya, right? Dasha balance. Some part of the dasha is over before birth, some part of the dasha the native goes on. There is no such thing in Rashi dashas. Also, in nakshatra dashas, what happened? Dasha can change any time in the year. This also does not happen with Rashi dasha. Rashi dasha changes from birthday to birthday. Birthday to birthday. One thing. Another thing is there is no calculation for past. Right, so the dasha starts from birth. And there is no portion of the dasha which you say have already passed before birth. These two things are further two more specialities with Rashi dashas. In the calculation, the next thing is what is the dasha year, for how long the dasha will go on. For the dasha year, you calculate from the Rashi to Rashi Lord. If the Rashi is male, you calculate in direct order what is told earlier, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 houses. Right? If the dasha is female, then you calculate in reverse order, right? 1, 12, 11, 10, what is told earlier. Whatever number you find from calculating Rashi to Rashi Lord, that is the year of dasha. So if the dasha lord is in second house and it is a male Rashi, there are 2 years of dasha. If the dasha lord is in 12th house and it is a female Rashi, it is 2 years of dasha, so on and so forth. If the lord is in Rashi, then in that particular scenario, the dasha will be of 12 years. And if the lord is in seventh house from the Rashi, then dasha will be of 10 years by default. In this, further antardashas can also be calculated, but this much is enough for our example, so I will not explain antardashas to you. Just up to Mahadasha level, it will be okay. Now, let's do a particular calculation. Let's take a horoscope, and on that, you apply this dasha. Right? So that you know how to do it. For example, say I take this, I take horoscope of Mukesh Ambani. So in the horoscope of Mukesh Ambani, it is Libra ascendant. It is a male ascendant. So first dasha will be of Libra. Next dasha will be of, now it will go into direct order. Next dasha of Scorpio. Next dasha of Sagittarius. I will be writing my calculations on the other side. After Sagittarius, there will be dasha of Capricorn. Then there will be dasha of Aquarius. Then there will be dasha of Pisces, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, and Libra. Then you have to calculate dasha years. So Libra, the lord of Libra is in seventh from Libra, 10 years of dasha. Lord of Scorpio, reverse calculation have to be done, but it is in seventh from Scorpio, so 10 years of Dasha. Lord of Sagittarius, direct calculation, ninth from Sagittarius, 9 years of Dasha. Lord of Capricorn is in third house, reverse calculation, Capricorn is a female Rashi, 3 years of Dasha. Lord of Aquarius, direct calculation, is in 10th house from Aquarius, 10 years of Dasha. Lord of Pisces, reverse calculation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 houses from Pisces, so 8 years of Dasha. Lord of Aries, male Rashi, direct calculation is in 2nd house from Aries, 2 years of Dasha. Lord of Taurus, reverse calculation is in 2nd house from Taurus, 2 years of Dasha. Lord of Gemini, Gemini is a male Rashi, direct calculation, Lord is situated in 11th house from Gemini, 11 years of Dasha. Cancer, reverse calculation, Lord is situated in 8th house from Cancer, 8 years of Dasha. Leo, direct calculation, Lord is situated in 9th house from Leo, 9 years of Dasha. Virgo, reverse calculation, female Rashi, Lord is situated in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 Rashis away from Virgo, 6 years of Dasha. Libra was the first Dasha itself, Libra shall not repeat. Sorry. And so 12 Dashas will be there. Now, Mukesh Ambani is born in 1957. So we calculate the Dasha durations, right? So 1957 plus 10 years up to 1967. Then next 10 years, 1977. Then next 9 years, 1986. Then next 3 years, 1989. Then next 10 years, 1999. Then next 8 years, 2007. Then 2 years, 2009. Then 2 years, 2011. Then 11 years, 2022. Then 8 years, 2030. Then 9 years, 2039. Then 6 years, 2045. So right now, Taurus Dasha ends in 2011. So from his birthday in 2011 all up to 2022, for 11 years, Gemini Dasha is running. Now, to see the result of Gemini Dasha, how do you see the result of Gemini Dasha? It is a simple, simple task. Right? Analysis of Gemini Dasha, it is very easy. See, Gemini Dasha, as I told in the beginning itself, the analysis is very easy, right? You have to see Dasha Rashi. You have to see, you can make the Dasha Rashi as an ascendant and read the horoscope therefrom, easiest method. This you can do, and apart from this, the planet in the Dasha Rashi, the planet influencing the Dasha Rashi, the condition of the Dasha Rashi Lord talks about the events in detail. Right? For example, as we have seen, 2011 to 2022, he's running Gemini Dasha. How will be the results in this Gemini Dasha? To see that, you check Gemini Rashi. First of all, Gemini Rashi, there is no planet. Gemini, there is an influence of Rahu. This Rahu, Gemini, in Gemini astrology, Rahu is not considered very good. Because there is influence of Rahu on the Rashi of Gemini, in 2021, there was a bomb scare that happened with him. 2023, there was death threat that happened with him as well. And right in the beginning, in 2014, there was an FIR against him as well because of this Rahu. Okay. But apart from Rahu, Moon is also influencing the Dasha Rashi, and Moon is a beneficial planet. It was just a scare. It was just a threat. It was just an FIR. Nothing is happening. Why? Because Moon, beneficial planet, is influencing Gemini. In Gemini astrology, I am taking normal planetary aspects each and every time. Right? We have to go by that. Right? So because Moon, a beneficial planet, is influencing there, if only malefic planet is influencing the Dasha Rashi, the Dasha gives bad result. Only beneficial planet is influencing the Dasha Rashi, Dasha gives good result. Both benefic and malefic planets are influencing the Dasha Rashi, then Dasha Rashi have mixed results. That is the case. Now, if you see the Lord of Gemini, that is Mercury, that is situated in Aries, is going into Scorpio Navamsh. It is Rashi and Navamsh of the same planet, which according to me should be taken as Virgottam, because of which he have recently purchased a 1,000 crore airplane as well. Right. And Dasha Lord being Virgottam, he is also now relieved from all of his family responsibilities, having recently married his youngest child, if I am not mistaken. Right. Because of this reason also, the Dasha Lord Mercury being situated in 11th from the Dasha Rashi, the Dasha gives him a lot of gains. And as per my research, the planet Mercury is Virgottam as well. Because of which, in 2015, he was awarded as, you know, fifth greatest Indian philanthropist. In 2016, he was the 36th richest person. Also became member of National Academy of Engineering, and multiple two, three more awards he also got. In 2018, he became Asia's richest person as well. Right. So the simple point is that in Rashi Dashas, when you have to analyze Rashi, there's a simple task, right? You take the Rashi under consideration, you take the aspect and placement of planet. If this aspect and placement of planet is of a beneficial planet, there is a good result. Malefic planet, there are bad results. Mixed planets, there are mixed results. But in these mixed planets also, you will see which is more powerful, benefic or malefic. Based on that, you will decide whether the result is benefic or not. The influences of a powerful planet, powerful result, gain of name, fame, power, status is there. The result is of a weak planet. The person suffers weak condition. This you see. Apart from that, you see the situation of Lord. If the Lord is powerful, if the Lord is the person in the Dasha is powerful. The difference between the Lord of the Rashi and the planet in the Rashi is planet in the Rashi, planet influencing the Rashi is planet in the Rashi, planet influencing the Rashi indicates what is happening with you in the Dasha. Whereas Lord of the Rashi indicates your condition in the Dasha. So Lord of the Rashi is powerful, you gain power. Lord of the Rashi is well placed from the Rashi. Right. Then your condition is also well placed. Lord of the Rashi is weak, your condition is weak. The Lord of the Rashi is ill placed from the Rashi, then the condition of the native is also ill placed. Right? This way, very simply, things can be analyzed. Right? Particularly, if you make that particular Dasha Rashi, whose Dasha is running as an ascendant, the result will be even more simpler. But now, here, the point. Dasha Karak, right? The basic thing, because we started it, is of the Dasha Karak. Dasha Karak in Gemini astrology. To simplify the Dasha calculation, we do one thing. Calculate Antardasha. If you want to see the result of Antardasha even more clearly, I am telling you that the Antardasha may or may not be calculated also, that is very fine. But you know Antardasha have a very high importance in Mahadasha also. You take Dasha duration and divide it by 12. Dasha duration divided by 12. The Dasha is running of Gemini, which is from 2011 to 2022. This is 11-year long Dasha. If you divide it into 12 parts, what will be the answer? 11 years and 1 year having 12 months, these are a total of 132 months. Divided into 12 parts, it is 11 months each. In a simple task, for a dasha of 1 year, the antardasha is of 1 month each. For a dasha of 2 years, antardasha is of 2 months each, so on and so forth. Right? So this calculation is not needed. This is a standard rule. He is born in April 1957. So dasha starts from April. Dasha will start from April 2011. Right? The first antardasha will be up to March. 11 month is there, na? March 2012. The first Antardasha duration. Then next will be February 2013. Then January 2014. Then December 2015. November 2016. October 2017. September 2018, August 2019, July 2020, June 2021, May 2022, right, and April 2023. Right, May 2022, the Dasha should be over. Right. These are the 11 Antardashas. These are the 12 Antardashas, right? First Antardasha ending here, second Antardasha is ending here, the third Antardasha, fourth Antardasha, fifth Antardasha, sixth Antardasha, seventh Antardasha, eighth Antardasha, ninth Antardasha, tenth Antardasha, 11th Antardasha, and 12th Antardasha is ending at April 2023. Right? How it is supposed to go. Now, what you can do is, because the Dasha is of Gemini, Gemini is a male Rashi, so there will be direct calculation. First Dasha will be of Gemini, second will be of Cancer, next will be of Leo. Either you can go this way, right? The first Antardasha is of Gemini, the next is of Cancer, next is of Leo, next is of Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, Aries, Taurus. Either these you can take as different Antardashas, right? Right. And you can see the events in detail right here. Or what you can do is you can take Dashakarak. You can find the Dashakarak of Gemini astrology. Now, to find the Dasha Karak, what you do, take the placement of Dasha Lord. Then the next planets are the next planet as per the degree are the next to next significators, and in such way you will find nine significators, nine planets will be there. We have to find the significator for 12 Antardashas. The significator of the first dasha will also be the significator of 10th dasha. The significator of second dasha will be the significator of 11th dasha. And the significator of sixth dasha will be the significator of 12th dasha. I will simplify it for you. Let's go to the horoscope of Mukesh Ambani once again. The dasha is of Gemini. Mercury is the Lord. So Mercury is the significator of first dasha. Mercury is situated at 23 degree. The same sign have Sun 5 degrees behind Mercury. We don't take it. Venus 6 degrees behind Mercury. We don't take it. Ketu 25 degrees after Mercury. So the second Antardasha is indicated by Ketu. After Aries, you go to Taurus. Only Mars is situated there. So Mars is the third significator. After that, Gemini is empty. Cancer is empty. Leo is having Jupiter. Jupiter is the next significator. Then Virgo is empty. Libra is having Rahu. Rahu is the next significator. You are not able to see it. Just a second. Try the next infinity. After that, in Scorpio, there is Saturn. Saturn is the next significator. After that, in Sagittarius, there is Moon. Moon is the next significator. Then, Capricorn is empty. Aquarius is empty. Pisces is empty. Then you come to Aries. Aries, lowest degree planet, is Sun, the significator of the next. Right? After that, situated planet is Venus. That is the significator of the next. Right, we started from Mercury. Ketu was already covered, right? So Mercury is the first significator, Ketu is the second significator, Mars is the third significator, Jupiter is fourth significator, Rahu is fifth significator, Saturn is sixth significator, Moon is seventh significator, Sun is eighth significator, Venus is ninth significator. First significator, Mercury, is the significator of 10th as well, 10th portion of Dasha. Second significator, Ketu, is the significator of 11th as well, and sixth significator, Saturn, is the significator of 12th as well. 12th Antardasha, you may say. Right. 12th Antardasha, you can say. 12th portion of Dasha, you can say whatever you want to say. So, this way. Now, once you have calculated the Antardasha, what result is going to happen in Antardasha? To do that, either you can go by the setup, right? That if the Dasha starts from Gemini, there will be 12 Antardashas in the Rashi. And those 12 Antardashas will be of the 12 Rashis starting from Gemini, calculating in the direct or reverse order. You can go by this way. But better than this way is that you find the 12 Dashakarak and you will say that in first Antardasha, whatever result indicated by Mercury will happen. Second Antardasha, the result indicated by Ketu will happen. Third Antardasha, result indicated by Mars will happen. Fourth Antardasha, result indicated by Jupiter will happen. To see this result, what you do, you make Gemini as an ascendant. And making Gemini as an ascendant, you predict further results, right? For example, let's do a normal search. Mukesh Ambani. Let's see a few things. Education career 2014. February 2014, a first information report alleging criminal offenses were filed against Ambani for alleged irregularities in the pricing of natural gas from the KG basin. This is happening in February 2014. Right? February 2013, Cancer Dasha is ending. Right? January 2014, Leo Dasha is also entering, ending. This is fourth Antardasha, which is from January 2014 up to December 2015 when this is happening. Fourth is indicated by Jupiter. Right. Now, if you see Jupiter from Gemini, Jupiter is situated in third house, which is not a placement for a beneficial planet to be in. Thus, FIR is happening in this period. Right. This is one thing. Few major events we will see. Next, what is in as of 2015? When we don't have a month for the result, we will not go by that. Right. He surpassed Jack Ma, executive chairman of Alibaba Group, to become Asia's richest person with a net worth of $44.3 billion in July 2018. This is happening in July 2018. July 2018, if you see, from October 2017 to September 2018 is Sagittarius Dasha, seventh Antardasha. Sorry, Sagittarius Antardasha, seventh Antardasha. The seventh is represented by Moon in the table. Right? If you see Moon is the beneficial planet which is influencing the Dasha Rashi Gemini. So, good result is indicated. Moon is also the significator of wealth. So, yes, the good result is seen. Right? Good. Awards and honors is talking about personal life 2019. So, TIA, your brother. On July 12th to 14th, 2024, the wedding of Anant Ambani and Radhika Merchant was held as a 3-day event that took place at the Antilia Building in Jio Convention Center in Mumbai. It has been described as India's wedding of the year and India's own royal wedding. The New York Times described it as introducing the world to India's gilded age. Estimates for the wedding costs range from $300 million to $600 million and had led to criticism regarding wealth inequality in India. Anant Ambani recently donated a crown to Lal Bagcha Raja worth 15 crores. Okay. July 12th to 14th, 2024. July 12th to 14th, 2024. The Dasha is supposed to end in 2023, right? So this is happening in the next Dasha of Cancer, which is from right 2020 to 2022 to 2030, right? So Cancer Dasha, the analysis of Cancer Dasha also, as I just explained to you, you can do and predict the result accordingly. This is Dashakarak. The concept of Dashakarak, once again, to reiterate it, You see the Dasha Lord, where the Dasha Lord is situated in, and mark the degree of the Dasha Lord. Any planet coming in the same Rashi after the degree of the Dasha Lord is the significator of next portion of Dashas. Then you continue in the Rashi, order of the Rashi, always direct order, never reverse order. In the direct order, the planet situated in next and next Rashis, going by the degrees, the planet having the lowest degree coming first and highest degree after that. You make 12 significators, which represents the 12 Antardashas of a Dasha Rashi. And you predict result accordingly. In my experience, rather than finding, rather by going by the words of the sages that take the dasha duration divided by 12 to find the antardasha duration and give that antardasha to, 12 rashis from the Mahadasha Rashi in the order of Mahadasha Rashi, rather by going through this way, finding the dasha karak and taking the Dasha Karak as the ruler of Antardashas and analyzing the results accordingly have proven to be better in timing events through Gemini astrology. Right? This is, traditionally, Dasha Karak is something that is analyzed along with Antardasha Rashi. From my experience, I am telling you that completely ignore the Antardasha Rashi, just go by Dasha Karak. This is Dasha Karak is a better way. In this Dasha Karak also, in finding this Dasha Karak also, the degree of planet is being used. In the first principle that I taught you in the source of strength also, directly degrees are used, minutes are not used. So there is no way and there is no chance of confusion. There is nothing as such that we can say that Gemini have not used the degree of planets. Certainly he have used degrees of planets at proper appropriate places. They have used the degrees of planets, right? But the point nowadays, the reality today is that people, when it comes to Gemini astrology, they only know the name of the seven Charakarakas, Atmakarak, etc., and Arud, etc., they know. And just based on that, people start making YouTube videos, start teaching Gemini astrology. They do not know Gemini astrology in depth. So such people sometimes feel uncomfortable that, oh, if we are not using degrees to find Atmakarak, then are the degrees of planets not useful in Gemini astrology? It is not so. One should learn the system in depth, practice it for some years, and only after that start teaching and talking about it. This is the correct way to do it. People are not ascribing to this way. It is their loss, not our loss. My point was just to clarify to you while giving two very precious techniques of mine regarding how degrees are used in Gemini astrology. I believe you will use it to make predictions, which will make your predictions better and make your Gemini analysis simple. Thank you.